So good morning, my dear students. In the previous class, we have discussed about nature of matter. Now, the matter is classified as pure and impure. The matter of pure matter is classified as elements and compounds. Elements and compounds. Again, so what is meant by elements? Different types of matter, different kinds of matter made up of certain simple substances are called elements. Okay, different kinds of matter, whatever you take, chalk is sand, brick, and whatever it is, different kinds of matter made up of certain simple substances are called elements. Now, what is meant by compound? Compound means two or more elements combined. Combine themselves. Two or more elements combine themselves are called compounds. Okay. To form compounds. Okay. Elements are different kinds of matter made up of certain simple substances are called elements. But compounds, two or more elements combine themselves to form compounds. So the matter is classified as pure and impure. Pure and impure. Again, the pure substances or matter is classified as elements or compounds. Again, the elements are classified as metals or non-metals. Okay, what is the definition of the elements? Different kinds of matter made up of certain simple substances are called elements. And compound, two or more elements combine themselves to form compounds. Now, elements are classified as metals and non-metals. non-metals. Again, the classified as metals and non-metals. And by the based on physical properties and based on chemical properties, the chemists have discovered 119 elements. Okay, the elements are classified as metals and non-metals based on physical properties and based on chemical properties. Chemists have discovered 119 elements so far. 119 elements they have discovered so far, and okay, another point. An element is a pure substance. Made up of one kind of atom, and an element is a pure substance made up of one kind of atom. Here characters of elements. An element is pure substance made up of one kind of atom, and at an atom is a smallest unit of element. It shows all the properties of an element. Okay, an element is pure substance made up of one kind of atom. An atom is the smallest unit of element. It shows all the properties of an element. So these are the characteristics of the elements, and we have so far 119. We have 119 elements so far, and elements are classified metals and non-metals. Okay, an element is pure substance and made up of one kind of atom. An atom is an element, smallest unit of element. It shows all the properties of an element, and we have 119 elements so far. And the elements are classified as metals and non-metals. Okay, now about metals. And first one, it should have lustre means it should have it should be lustre and it should have metallic glow. Lustre means glow. Lustre means glow. It should be lustre. The metals are lustre and it should have metallic glow. And metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. It should be lustre and it should have metallic glow. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity, and it should be ductile means it should be drawn. It should be drawn into wires and it should be malleable and identical equal to it should be beaten as sheets. Okay, it should be lustre means glow. It should have metallic glow, and metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. And it should be ductile. Ductile means wire. It should be drawn into wires. So if you have any iron rod, iron is a metal. So we can get the wires from the iron, and we can get the sheets, iron wire or iron sheets from the iron rod. So it should be ductile. It should be drawn into wires, and it should be malleable, and it should be beaten as sheets. And it should be a solid at room temperature. Okay, it should be solid at room temperature. Okay, it should be lustre. It should have metallic glow, and metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. And ductile, it should be drawn into wires. Ductile means drawn into wires. It should be malleable, and it should be beaten as sheets. It should be solid at room temperature. And another one, it should be a sonorous. It should be a sonorous it should be sonorous or it should be produced sonorous sound. Sonorous sound by being hit. Okay, it should be sonorous sound. It should be produce sonorous sound by being hit. And some more exceptions are there. That's some more exceptions are there, and that are mercury and gallium are liquid metals at 30°C. Mercury and gallium are liquid metals at 30°C, and zinc is not malleable. Zinc is not malleable, and ductile at room temperature. Again, it should be. Some more exceptions are there in metals. Mercury and gallium are liquid metals at 30°C. Zinc is not malleable and ductile. are the exceptions for the metals. Now we are discussing about non-metals. Okay, for non-metals we can it has no lustre, and non-metals are not good conductors of good conductors of good conductors of heat and electricity and non-metals are not ductile and non-metals are not malleable and they are not produce sound and They are not sonorous. It is a gas or brittle solid at room temperature. These are the properties of non-metals. So non-metals are nothing but gases state. Non-metals are nothing but gases, and some more exceptions are there. Non-metals, that means graphite. Graphite is a lustre and it is a good conductor of good conductor of heat and electricity. Good conductor of electricity. Graphite should be lustre and it is a good conductor of heat and electricity. And bromine is a liquid non-metal is a liquid non-metal. Liquid non-metal. Okay, graphite is a rusty and it is a good conductor of heat and electricity. Bromine is a liquid non-metal. These are the two exceptions of non-metal. J.J. Berzelius suggested a method to represent a element. Okay, J.J. Berzelius suggested a method to represent a element. Like, we should take first, for example, hydrogen. So we should take hydrogen is an element. To represent the hydrogen element as an element, we should take first letter H. Aluminium or cadmium. So we have, for aluminium, we have to take two letters. First two letters, aluminium. Minium. So like that, J.J. Berzelius suggested a method to represent an element. Like, symbol. Okay, and boron, that means B. Next, carbon. Carbon C and fluorine F, hydrogen H. In this process, we should take only first letter. In boron, take to represent the element, take B, only first letter. Carbon C, fluorine F, hydrogen H, and some more. So we have to take first letter and another two letters. Aluminium. So to represent aluminium, we should take two letters Al. And cadmium, C. And strontium, that means Sr, strontium. Aluminium, Al, cadmium. So we should, to represent cadmium, we have to take Cd. Strontium,
aluminium A, aluminium AL, zinc. You should take Zn, Zn. Carbon B, sorry, boron B, carbon C, fluorine F, hydrogen H, aluminium AL, cadmium CD, strontium SR, zinc Zn.
Okay,
silver Az, sodium Na, tin Sn, tungsten, wolfram from W. These are the Latin words and symbols of the some elements what we have. Okay, students, and so far we discussed about the elements and symbols of the elements. In the next class, we have to learn compounds. Okay, students.